So our next speaker is Paul Abia from the Harvard Medical School and Boston's Children's Hospital. And he is going to be presenting a really fantastic use case using the Picture platform, integrating clinical and genomic sequencing data at large scale. So Paul, please.
Thanks for inviting me. And I'll be presenting the multiple examples of work that we're doing using the Picture platform. In the context of integrating very large-scale clinical and genomic data, including whole exome and whole genome sequencing data. The whole idea and concept of for the creation of the Picture platform was taking the analogy of Google Map, where you have all those different layers of information with satellite, postal code, traffic jams in real time. What we did is to look at, based on the I2B2 database model, that enables to have many different data types and how to extend it in the context of having full-scale genomic data into the same environment. And this was one of the first designing principle of making sure that all the data, including the genomic data, was into one single place. And then the second designing principle was to make sure to enable extracting the data using an API, a secured API, so that we can run the compute next to the data, where you would have an investigator producing many different data types, clinical data, genomic data, imaging data. And in the context of having the compute available to analyze the data, is not that obvious. And so also in the context of sharing this data with another investigator. So what we did is to create a secured, very secured environment in the cloud where the data is just next to the analytics. So it enabled to scale with no limit based on using the cloud compute. So this was the second design principle in the creation of the Picture platform to be fully scalable for the analysis. And how it looks like for an investigator is either using a search portal where you can run queries with Boolean queries, where you just a search bar and entering any clinical or genomic data as a starting point. For example, a variant identifier or a gene name, or a nomad minor allele frequency, and directly from the search portal, and that enables using the Picture API to query the data still stored into the Picture high performance data store. But in order to run full scale analysis, you won't do it directly from a user interface. The user interface is only to generate hypotheses. So that's why we created also, and we're using the best tools in the context of doing reproducible science using Jupyter Notebooks, running with R and RStudio and Python, to be able to run and explore all the exact same data that you can have from the search portal, the clinical and the full genome data, same from using the Picture API, which is hosted using the Picture High Performance Data Store, that enables to query and to run the full scan analysis. And so what we did is by creating this portal on, and when we use the version running on Amazon, then to use the full scalability of Amazon SageMaker and TensorFlow to be able to scale our analysis. One of the example led by Ken Mendel, who just presented on another aspect of what he's doing at Boston Children's Hospital, is to how to bring together at the aggregate level, but also at the patient level data into a federated network. So patient level data federated into one central environment with this discovery portal and analysis portal across the three main pediatric hospitals, Boston Children's Hospital, Cincinnati, and CHOP, which is now scaling up with also WashU and UPMC, that enables to have one central environment where you can have aggregate counts, but also patient level data with, of course, all the appropriate agreements. And that's how a piece that was published showing how within the Green Network, the Genomic Research and Innovation Network, where you can query across the institution with the clinical data, so like a Shrine-like query, but also including genomic data directly from your query. And that enables directly from a user interface to be able to have access to all this information. And this same framework has been implemented now in many different research projects based on using I2B2. For example, with the UDN Underdiagnosis Network project, the Boston Children's Hospital Biobank, the PCORI network with Phelan-McDermid syndrome, a rare disease, but also the NLHBI Biodata Catalyst that is a very large scale initiative integrating more than 60 NLHBI, so from the NIH, National Heart, Lung and Blood Institute research cohort that includes Framingham Heart Study, Cardia, Women's Health Initiative, where there's, for example, for Framingham Heart Study, more than 60,000 clinical variables per patient. So very deep, well-registered with a real prospective cohort of patients linked to all genome sequencing data, not SNP arrays, not exome data, all genome sequencing data. And we're talking about 186,000 full genomes linked to all the very deep clinical data. And this is what we've achieved using the Picture platform in the context of Biodata Catalyst, including also harmonized phenotypes across 17 of the studies that enables to have for the both aspects, the discovery portal that enables to have the search interface with the Picture user interface, but also access to the API to using the R and Python client to run the full-scale analysis. The queries that can be launched based on the genomic data is using variant annotations, so that it's into the Picture. We do not load the FASTQ file or the BAM file. We load the annotated VCF, and we have a full pipeline of integration, which I'll share the links at the end of the presentation, that enables using the GATK out-of-the-box process, where you can directly integrate all this data into Picture, when you can afterwards query based on the variant's consequence, but using the sequence ontology, the variant class, with, for example, insertion, deletion, SNPs array, variant severity, and using the variant frequency from NOMAD. And so, and those are just examples of variant annotation, but there's no limit of how many annotations you want to add within this system. And from the user interface where you can make all those queries, then on the API, and we are delivering Jupyter notebooks that are publicly available in this repo, access to data using the Picture API across all our various projects. And in this case, we're looking at the NLHBI Biodata Catalyst for this project with the Python and the R notebook that enables to show how you can, using those cohorts, run a phenom-wide association study, make queries across the harmonized variable, and this is publicly available. So even if you don't have access to this data yet, you can, because you need to be under the IRB and make a request to DBGAP to have access to the StopMed cohort, you can still see how the data is analyzed by others using this API. And showing here the Jupyter notebooks, where you have all the code showing you with one click how you can fully reproduce the full analysis. And those analysis using the Picture API can run today within the Biodata Catalyst project on the Seven Bridges platform, where there's the Picture API being embedded and that has been incorporated within this vendor commercial product that enables you to run large-scale genomic analysis, where there's the Picture API, but also on the Broad Institute Terra platform, where there's also the Picture API that has been implemented that enables anyone to have access to this complex clinical data. And now, because of looking how the Seven Bridges platform was creating and using the compute, how the Broad created using Google, in a partnership with Amazon Web Services, we have designed and co-developed a new analytic portal called internally Pufferfish, but Pufferfish was the name of our prototype, and it was named by my 5-year-old daughter because she liked that, the book of Pufferfish. But that enables to have the JupyterLab, RStudio, Python, TensorFlow, all the power of Amazon into a very nice user interface for investigators to directly run the various queries. So this is a very, very scalable analytic platform. And because this was just a pilot with Amazon, but they really, really liked it. And then it's now becoming a real Amazon product that will be released at the end of July of this year. And it will be named AWS Galileo Gateway. They prefer to call it Galileo than Pufferfish, fine. But what's great is now it's maintained, something that we developed, but now it's maintained by Amazon. So it's a very, there's more than 20 developers from Amazon maintaining this that enables you to have something very scalable that is a competitor to the Broad Terra and Seven Bridges platform. Because looking at how did we design this Pufferfish now called Galileo, is looking at the best aspects of this platform, but not taking what we didn't like. And so we're completely re-engineering something that is fits our need and that I think will help a lot of people here in this call. And now, how does this platform helps in the context of COVID, where NLHBI, for all the grants that are submitted from the National Heart, Lung, and Blood Institute that are related to COVID, where it's mentioned that the investigators will have to deposit the data and run the analysis in this Biodata Catalyst platform. So this is becoming the hub where all NLHBI investigators will deposit the data from all the prospective cohorts related to COVID or addition to existing cohorts. So that's how with Framingham and Women's Health Initiative started to look at how they will be bringing all the data within directly this environment for COVID. And this will include clinical data of the patients, genomic data from the virus, but also from the patients, and X-rays and EKG and also cardiac MRI that I forgot to add here. And also at Boston Children's Hospital, again with Ken Mandel, within his program of Precision Link, what we have set is a database available for approved BCH investigators, where there's as of 2 days ago, in June 9th, the 6,000 patients that have been tested for COVID. So you will have the cases, but also controls that were negative to COVID, and with 143 patients that are positive to COVID, and as of two days ago, 28 cases of patients with the new MISC syndrome in children. And so this has been approved and include all the clinical notes and available for all approved BCH investigators. And so those are links to all everything that I presented. That everything is open source under an Apache 2 license. And also, because many different sites wouldn't use the cloud yet, so that's why something completely new that wasn't presented last year that we've created is a picture all-in-one, which enables anyone to download and to install picture into a virtual machine on your on-prem server, completely disconnected to the cloud and disconnected from any environment, so you can have it running within your own environment and it doesn't have to be running in the cloud. Before, as everything has to be on the cloud, but now there's a version of picture, which is called picture all-in-one, that enables to bring everything together. So for you to get started with a production grade environment with everything into one central VM so that you can, with all the loaders from the clinical data and the genomic data, including the whole genome sequencing data loader using Jenkins that is also preloaded. So it enables you to very quickly maintain this platform. And all this wouldn't have been possible without this great lab. So this further is kind of old because a lot of people came in, people also left. But this was the time when we were able to meet all together. But everything that I've presented wouldn't have been possible without this outstanding team. So this was a very quick introduction to what we're doing using the Picture platform in the context of integrating large-scale clinical and genomic data.
So Paul, this picture reminds me of the good old days, like 4 months ago when we could actually be with people. Boy, I miss that.